Welcome to this seventh video of basic concept in geometry. Till now we have learned about the basic concepts, point, line, ray and plane and terminology required with it, congruence, comparison, midpoint and so on. Now let's solve practice set 1.2. Now in the first question there is a table given and here we can see some points are given and their coordinates on a number line are given. And we have been asked to decide whether the given pairs of segments are congruent or not. There are three pairs given, but I have taken one different pair. From this example, you can solve the questions given in the practice set, actual questions in the practice set by your own. Now, what is this pair I have taken or chosen? It is, you have to decide about the segment DE and AD, whether these two segments are congruent or not. How can we decide two segments are congruent or not? For that, we should know their lengths. To find their lengths, and finding length of a segment is nothing but it's finding the distance between their aim points. From these coordinates, we will find these lengths and then we will compare. Okay. So, to find first what is the length of segment DE, what we have to do? For finding this, we will see the coordinate of D. What is the coordinate of D? It is -7. And what is the coordinate of E? It is 9. Now we have to compare this coordinate which is bigger. Now we can understand as one is negative and one is positive. So -7 and 9 if you want to compare, surely positive 9 is going to be bigger than -7. So from this coordinate we are going to find this distance. How? We will write the greater coordinate minus smaller coordinate. This is our thing to remember. What is the greater coordinate? 9. Minus smaller coordinate. CO is coordinate. It's -7. So when we will do subtraction between these two, greater minus smaller, we can get its distance. So this is 9 minus minus will become plus and 9 plus 7. So length DE is going to be 9 plus 7, that is 16. So this is the distance between two endpoints of D and E, and it is the length of segment D. Now let's find what is the length AD. This is the second thing we will find. To find length between AD, what is the coordinate of A? It is -3 and D is -7. Now both are negative. Let me write here in bracket, one is -3 and other is -7. Now we need to find the relationship of greater smaller in between this. Sometimes students go wrong here, so they have to do a simple technique or a smart tip for them. Think about positive 7 and 3 and positive 7. As this 3 is smaller than 7, just do the relation between this. The meaning of this symbol, this is exactly opposite of therefore. The meaning of this as or because. This is because this relationship. Okay. You need not to write. You have to think about this and you can write this. Okay, now here this is the bigger coordinate and this is the smaller. So find this distance. You have to use this formula like we will write first the bigger distance or greater coordinate. Greater coordinate minus smaller coordinate minus 7. Greater coordinate subtract smaller coordinate. So this way if we write, this is -3. Open this bracket, simplify. Minus minus will become plus 7. Now 1 minus 1 plus. You have to do subtraction. Signs are different. So 7 minus 3 is going to be 4. And as 7 is bigger, its sign is positive, the distance is going to be 4. So, as we have got these two distances between length DE and AD, let's compare these two distances. 16 is bigger than this. So we can say as length DE is greater than length AD. So what is our answer? Our answer is going to be segment DE. Are they congruent? They are not congruent. So, if they are not, we'll put the congruent sign and we can put a slash over it. They are not congruent to segment AD. If we find these both lengths are equal, then we can say these two segments are congruent. Either you can use this symbol or you can write in words, segment AD is not congruent. you can write this using word also with segment AD. So like this we can solve this question number 1. There are 3 pairs. You have to find the lengths of the given segments of the given pair. If they are equal, they are congruent. If they are not equal, they are not congruent. Okay. Now question number 2, 3, 4. I'll tell you quickly how to solve. I'm not going to write it on the board. They are very easy to understand. I just want you to show the presentation part of it. In question number 2, what we have, it is given that point M is midpoint of segment AB. Okay. And AB is at, what is given? Segment AB is at point M is midpoint. Midpoint of segment AB. So what you have to find? You have to find length A. So you have to find length AF. This is your question. Okay. So this is very much easy, but I'm just showing the presentation. So you will write your answer as length AM is equal to half of length AB. In bracket you can write the reason. This reason, point M is the midpoint of AB, and then you can write half. What is length AB? It is given 8, and therefore length AM is equal to 4. If you have given centimeter here, then you should write centimeter here also. If nothing is given, you need not to write anything. Or if you want, you can write say units here. Just it. Okay. So this is the presentation. Now question number 3 is similar to this. I'll read it for you. Point P is midpoint of segment AD. CP is 2.5. Length CD. You can draw a rough figure also for your understanding. That P is midpoint of CD. You can draw a CD ray. CD and P is the midpoint. Okay, this is P is the midpoint. So, if you draw the rough figure and put the values here, CP is given 2.5, then you have to find what is the length of CD. Now, here as you want to find the length of the original segment, when you know the half of it, how can you write your answer of this? Length CD is equal to, now it is going to be twice of CP, correct? 2 times length CP. Here we were knowing the, this was AB and we were knowing AM. Sorry, AB was 8 and we have to find this. So from this original to find this half, we multiplied by half. Now we here we know half part and we know the, want to know the full part. So this is going to be twice of it because this is 2.5, this is also 2.5 surely. And double of this, you can say it orally also, it is 5. But how to present this? So twice the CP. So where to multiply by half and where to multiply by 2? You can understand when you draw the figure related to it. So 2 times length CP, it is 2.5. Just think about it, it is 25, it is going to be 50. Put a decimal point, 5.0 means 5. And therefore your answer will be length CD is going to be equal to 5. Okay. When you write this, you can write this point C, point P is the midpoint of CD in bracket. You can write. So this simple sums for 1-1 mark, you can solve this. But if you go wrong in multiplication by half or 2, you will not get your correct answer. Okay. And one more simple question in this is question number 4. It is if length AB is 5, BP is 2, and AP is 3.4. You have to compare the segment. What are the 3 segments given? AB is 5, the centimeter. BP is given 2 centimeter. This is 5 centimeter, and the another is AP is 3.4 centimeter. Now you have to compare. How you have to compare? You can take these two pairs. This is 3 pairs, and you can compare. If AB, you can see 5 is bigger than 2, then you can write AB is bigger than BP. Like this you can write your answer. When you compare these two, BP and AP. Now 2 is smaller, AP is bigger. So BP is smaller than AP. And first and third, 5 is bigger than AP. So you can say AB is bigger than AP. So this is just comparison, and you can write this answer in this way. That is your answer. So much explanation is not required over here. So all these sums are very much easy. The next question we will see in the next video.